Every year in January or February, Tamil and Malayali Hindus celebrate the Thaipusam festival. This religious festival is different from other religious festivals celebrated in India, as devotees go to extreme lengths to show their devotion. Devotees pierce parts of their bodies and then take part in a procession. So, why exactly do people choose to go through this pain and opt for such piercings during Thaipusam? Thaipusam festival commemorates the occasion when goddess Parvati gave her son Murugan a spear to vanquish the evil demon Surapadam. But unlike other Indian festivals, bodily self-mortification is a part of a ceremonial act of devotional sacrifice during the festival. During the Thaipusam festival, devotees dance, make food offerings, and pierce their body parts in honor of Lord Murugan. During the procession, some devotees carry kavadi, a semicircular decorated canopy, to the temple of Lord Murugan. The pilgrimage, at its simplest form, includes walking the route carrying a pot of milk, but mortification of the flesh is also common among devotees. Pilgrims often pierce their skin, tongue, or cheek with skewers. Some even pierce their tongues or cheek all the way through with a small spear. Devotees believe that worshipping Lord Murugan in this way will make them healthy and help clear their karmic debt. Thaipusam is not just celebrated in India, but also in other South Asian countries with a considerable Tamil diaspora. Devotees make offerings and pray to Lord Murugan to fulfill their wishes. When those wishes are fulfilled, devotees express their gratitude by undergoing extreme piercing and participating in the Thaipusam procession. Many display the extent of their devotion by carrying heavy kavadis, but these kavadis are not held in their hand. They are affixed to their bodies with sharp metal spikes that are hammered into the skin. Though a significant number of devotees go through extreme piercings in India, Malaysia, and other South Asian countries during Thaipusam, only a few cases of serious health implications have been reported. There is no clarity whether there are no serious health implications of such acts or people just don't report it. One of the rare reported cases is that of a woman who reported painful swelling after she pierced a metal spear through her cheek during Thaipusam. Holy ash was applied to the affected area before and after the removal of the spear. Surprisingly, the patient did not have any bleeding during or after the piercing. However, she later developed a non-cancerous benign nodule at the sites of piercing. Whether there are any serious health implications of extreme piercing during Thaipusam is still unknown. Devotees believe that God protects them. Thus, extremely painful looking body mortification to express gratitude and devotion continues to be a part of Thaipusam.